We want to find the limit of this as n tends to infinity, right? What I do is, this I write as limit n tends to infinity. I take n cube common from this. When it comes out, it will become n to power 3 by 2, right? Root 1 minus 2 by n plus 1 by n cube, right? I take n to power 4 common from this. I take n to power 6 common from this. This will become n to power 6 by 4. So n to power 3 by 2. I take n to power 7 common from this. This is 5, fifth root, is it? So n to power 7 by 5, when it comes out, clear? Now I divide numerator denominator by n to power 3 by 2. So when I divide this, this will become 1, this will become n to power 4 by 3 minus 3 by 2, this will become 1, this will become n to power 7 by 5 minus 3 by 2, right? Now this is 8 minus 1 by 6, this would be minus 1 by 6, 1 by n to power 1 by 6, right? 14 minus 15 minus 1 by 10, 1 by n to power 1 by 10 is what becomes of this, right? Yes or no? As n tends to infinity, this will tend to 0, this will tend to 0, this whole thing will tend to 0, right? Yes or no? This will tend to 0, this will tend to 0, this will tend to 0, clear? And therefore, all that you are left with is 1 here and 1 there, because this tends to 0, as you can see. As n becomes larger and larger and larger, this will tend to 0, 1 by this, and this will tend to 0. And so you are left with 1 here and 1 here, and therefore the limit is going to be 1. Okay, then 4 part 2, someone said? No, it's not required? Okay. And then tell me, 5, anyone? 5? 5 rationalize. Okay, that means you want me to solve 5? Yeah, so that's all right. You should ask me to solve 5. X tends to 2, 2 to the power x plus 2 to the power 3 minus x minus 6 divided by 2 to the power minus x, square root of this, minus 2 to the power 1 minus x as x tends to 2, right? What you might want to do here is take 2 to the power x as some t. You could take 2 to the power x as some t here. So as x tends to 2, t tends to 4. Isn't it? So this will become like a limit. T tends to 4. T 8 by t minus 6, 2 to the power minus x by 2 means t to the power minus half, t to the power minus half, yes or no? Minus 2 by t as t tends to 4. Clear? this is like limit t squared minus 60 plus 8 divided by this t comes down here. So root t minus 2 as t tends to 4. Right? T minus 4 into t minus 2. This can be written as root t plus 2 into root t minus 2. That's all. And then plug in the value of t equal to 4, etc. Clear? Number 6, Purohit, you want, x tends to plus minus infinity, root x squared, what did you write that as? No, I have a feeling, you know, some of you would have made a conceptual error here, you would have perforce got the answer, but I still want to make sure that you understand this, because there is an issue here. Limit x tends to plus minus infinity, of course the first thing you would do is rationalize this. X tends to plus minus infinity, x squared minus 2x minus 1 minus x squared minus 7x minus 3. Right, you would have got this? Yes or no? Plus minus infinity. See, I'll tell you where people would have gone wrong. This is 5x plus 2. I can take x square common from this, x square common from this. Say for example, if I took x squared minus 2x minus 1 and I took x square common from this, root x squared into root 1 minus 2 by x minus 1, root x would be mod x, root x squared would be not x but would be mod x minus 1 by x squared, right? This root x squared would not be x but would be mod x, because see, if x tends to plus infinity it would have been plus x, but if x tends to minus infinity this root x squared would be minus x actually. So this root x squared is mod x, not x, but is, if it was x tending to only plus infinity then root x squared would have been the same as x, but since it's also tending to minus infinity then for minus infinity root x squared cannot be x, would be minus x, so that root x squared turns out to be a positive number. Right, so if I took x squared common from the whole thing, denominator root x squared 1 minus 2 by x minus 1 by x squared plus root 1 minus 7 by x minus 3 by x squared as x tends to plus minus infinity, right? This root x squared I would write as mod x. When x tends to plus infinity, this mod x would have been plus x. But when x tends to minus infinity, this mod x would be minus x. Say x tends to plus infinity. 5x plus 2. Then mod x becomes x. Right? Then this will become 5 plus 2 by x as x tends to plus infinity. 2 by x, 2 by x, 1 by x squared, 3 by x squared, etc. will tend to 0. All that you are left with is 5 divided by 2. 1 plus 1, 2. Right? If x was tending to minus infinity, then this mod x would have been minus x. Suppose x was tending to minus infinity, then this mod x would have been written as minus x. The minus would come out and the limit would then have been minus 5 by 2. So if x tends to plus minus infinity, it would be plus minus 5 by 2. Right? Bear that in mind. Right? See, this is easy because x cube plus 8 could be looked upon as the LCM of this, right? X squared minus 2x plus 4, a squared minus ab plus b squared becomes the numerator of this, minus 12. As x tends to 2, how about it? Sorry, x tends to minus 2. Yeah, x tends to minus 2. Otherwise, you would just put the value of x equal to 2 if it was only 2. Yeah, right. I hope all of you understand this. This is x plus 2 into x squared minus 2x plus 4. So, x cube plus 8 is the LCM for sure. This is what happens. Minus 12, right? This you can factorize. X plus 2 into x minus 4. X plus 2 into x minus 4. X plus 2 was the devil, which you, if you cancel, all that you need to do is plug in the value of x equal to minus 2 and you'll obtain the required limit. Right? Okay. Number 8. You want me to solve number 8? Can I wipe this off? Limit x tends to minus infinity root x squared plus 1 divided by 3x minus 6. Again, you know the same notion. If I take x squared out, it will become root x squared, which would be mod x, not x. Root 1 plus 1 by x squared. 3x minus 6. X tends to minus infinity. Now, as x tends to minus infinity, mod x will be minus x. Right. And now, of course, limit root 1 plus 1 by x squared divided by x. 3 minus 6 by x as x tends to minus infinity. So this would be 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3 would be the required limit. If you were reckless and you said, alright, let me divide by x. So this is wrong. What I am going to do next is wrong. And initially people do this. Dividing by x, you said, all right, this 3 minus 6 by x. And you said, well, as x tends to infinity, this would be plus 1 by 3, x tends to minus. I mean, you would be oblivious of this division now. So this would be wrong if you said, let me just divide by x, both numerator, denominator. No. In this case, x is not root x squared. X is minus root x squared because x is negative here. Right? So this would have been wrong. This is what you need. If it was just x tending to plus infinity, then this mod x would have been x. There would be no occurrence of this minus sign. And then it would have been plus 1 by 3 if x tends to plus infinity. Do you understand the subtle difference? Something like this I solved using remainder theorem, remember? No? R equal to 1 to n, limit n tending to infinity. Hey, r squared x, box of r squared x is greater than r squared x minus 1, but less than or equal to r squared x. Remember this? Why? Box of x is less than or equal to x and greater than x minus 1. Have I given you this inequality? So box of a number would be less than or equal to the number but will be greater than the number minus 1. Right? Huh? So if I took summation throughout, summation r squared x minus 1. All of it are from 1 to n. Less than summation box of r squared x less than or equal to summation r squared x r equal to 1 to n. Summation of this minus summation of 1. Summation of this means x will come out, summation r squared. Summation r squared is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6. That's summation r squared. Summation 1 is n. So minus n less than box of r squared x r equal to 1 to n less than or equal to x will come out. Summation r squared is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6. Right? And the whole thing now divided by n cubed. N cubed by n cubed n cubed. Yes or no? Right? Now look at this. This is x by 6. This n cubed, one of them will cancel this. The other one would make this 1 by 1 by n. Then 2 plus 1 by n. Right? This is what it would become. So as n tends to infinity, 1 by n and 1 by n would tend to 0. So this would be x by 6 into 2. That makes it x by 3. As n tends to infinity, this would tend to x by 3. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Again, this is the same thing as that. So this, as n tends to infinity, this like before, would tend to x by 3. This would tend to 0. As n tends to infinity, 1 by n squared. Right? So the upper bound function tends to x by 3. The lower bound function tends to x by 3. So limit of this as n tends to infinity will be x by 3 courtesy sandwich theorem. Right? So the limit of this is going to be x. Did I do something like this in the class? Last class? Yeah, something I might have done. Let's say summation rx by n squared. Did I do that? No? Did I? Say if you had. I didn't illustrate anything of this sort. Did I? Okay, no, I thought I would have given you this very template as in my class. So remember this from now on. Right? as a consequence of this, try in exactly the same way the following limit. Limit n tends to infinity, summation box rx, r equal to 1 to n by n squared, you'll be able to get. So work on the same premise, box rx less than or equal to rx, greater than rx minus 1, and do a summation, then divide by n squared. Obtain this also independently, not right now, but after you're done with the class, work on this limit as well. Yes, and then some n times, which would be less, absolutely alpha would be less than n. Yes, we could have done that also. Right. Okay. 10 we did in the class, did we? No. 11? Anyone who wants me to solve 11? 12? 13? 14? I'm sorry. 15? I did in the class. Mod sign. It will not exist. 16? You want me to solve? 17? Anyone who wants me to solve 17? Please feel free. You know, if you are the only one who's not solved that and you find others keeping quiet, you don't have to keep quiet. You can ask me to solve. Huh? Sorry? 5 is the answer for 17? Okay. 18 I discussed in the class. 19? You want me to solve? Okay. Obviously, you want to rationalize here. You want to rationalize this. Hello. So, when you rationalize this, 1 plus tan x minus 1 plus sin x. Right? This is limit tan x minus sin x, which is sin x into 1 minus cos x by cos x. Into x cubed into root 1 plus tan x plus root 1 plus sin x. As x tends to 0, I hope you realize what I've done. That tan x minus sin x is like a sin x common 1 by cos x minus 1. Which is sin x into 1 minus cos x, sin x into 1 minus cos x by cos x. That's tan x minus sin x. Right? As x tends to 0. Now, this, realize, could be written as limit x tends to 0, 1 by cos x into sin x by x into 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta by 2. And there is a x square remaining, so that I write as x by 2 whole squared into 4, right? Yes or no? And as x tends to 0, realize that this will tend to 2. This will tend to 2 as x tends to 0. This will tend to 1, this will be half, and this will be 2. You're done. Right? Sin theta. Sin square, sorry, 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta by 2 by theta square. This would be 1, half, 2. This will be 1. Finish? And then tell me, 20? Can I wipe this off? Are you done with this? X tends to 1, 1 minus x tan pi x by 2, right? This I can write as limit x tends to 1, 1 minus x by cot x, right? cot theta is tan 90 minus theta. As x tends to 1, yes or no? As x tends to 1, 1 minus x tends to 0. So we have tan theta. So we should bring a theta here so that theta by tan theta becomes 1. So we do a balancing fact here. Pi by 2 into 2 by pi. So then this will be theta by tan theta. As theta tends to 0, this would be 1. You are left with a 2 by pi there. And then 21. Can I wipe this off? Right. 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta by 2. One minus cos 2a is 2 sin squared a. 1 minus cos 2a is 2 sin squared a. Yes or no? This I can further write as twice limit sine squared x by 2 divided by sine squared x by 2 whole squared sine squared theta by theta squared. Sine squared theta by theta squared, right? Sine squared theta by theta squared. So that as x tends to 0, see this tends to 0, sine squared theta by theta squared would tend to 1. And then I need to balance this, right? So into x to power 4 divided by sine to power 4 x by 2. Balancing this as x tends to 0. What about this? Yes or no? Right? This would tend to 1, right? And what we are left with is twice limit x tends to 0. Sine x by 2 by x by 2. Whole to power 4, right? This goes up. Sine x by 2 by x by 2 whole to power 4. 1 by 16. This 2 to power 4 balanced here. Yes or no? So 1 by 8. Right? Fairly simple. Okay, 24, 23, not 23, someone said 23 also, okay, 23 also, yeah, let it be a class for everyone, if you've solved and someone else has not solved, let me also solve it for them, 22, you don't need help, right, this limit is 0, right? This I could write as limit hello sine a plus 2x minus sine a plus x plus sine a minus sine a plus x divided by x squared as x tends to 0. Yes or no? Or I could have actually right away combined these two. 2 sin c plus d by 2 cos c minus, then sin a plus x could have been taken common. That also I could have done. Wouldn't I realize what I'm saying? Sin c plus sin d, 2 sin c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2, I could have, right? So then sin a plus x would have been taken common from there. See, I could have also done this. In this limit, x tends to 0, sin c plus sin d, 2 sin c plus d by 2, cos c minus d by 2. By x squared as x tends to 0, and I can take 2 sin a plus x common minus 2 sin a plus x. Cos x minus 1 with a minus sign, 1 minus cos x by x squared as x tends to 0, 1 minus cos x, 2 sin square x by 2 by x by 2 whole squared, 4, etc. This would tend to sin a 1 by 4, etc. Right? You'll be able to obtain this limit from this point onwards. Yes. Right? Okay, then tell me. 24. See, I combined these two, sin c plus sin d, 2 sin c plus d by 2, cos c minus d by 2. And then 2, this cos x minus 1, because of the minus sign, it will become 1 minus cos x. Right? Shall we proceed? X tends to 0 from the greater than 0 side. Cos inverse x is sine inverse root 1 minus x squared. Cos inverse x is root is sine inverse root 1 minus x squared. Right? See, this will become 2x minus x squared, x, right, divided by, I bring the same thing, root x is anyways there, 2 minus x, 2 minus x balance there, as x tends to 0 from the greater than 0 side. Realize what I did here? So this is like sine inverse theta by theta, as theta tends to 0, that's going to be 1, root 2. Yes or no? Bless you. Sin inverse theta by theta, as theta tends to 0. As x tends to 0, this will tend to 0. So this will be 1 into root 2. So that makes it root 2. That makes it root 2. Very simple. This could be written as e power sine 2x minus 1 minus e power sine x minus 1. X by sine 2x, sorry, sine 2x into x by sine 2x, sine x into x by sine x, as x tends to 0, I hope you realize what the objective is. See, both these limits exist and are finite, therefore limit of the difference will be difference of the limits. I can treat these limits independently, right? And this I can manage this way. So e power something minus 1 by something, is something tends to 0 is 1 into 2 divided by 1. So that makes it 2 minus e power something minus 1 by something, something tends to 0 is 1. This would be 1. So 1, 2 minus 1 equal to 1. Minus cos d, 2 sin d minus c by 2 sin c plus d by 2. Now, by x cube, what I do is sin theta by theta I force here, sin theta by theta I force here, This 4 I balance here. Okay. And then there is this e power minus x, a minus b into a plus b, I balance in the numerator. E power minus 2x minus e power x. And there is an x that was remaining, that I balance here. And then limit as x tends to 0. See. See what I did here? 2 sine d minus c by 2 sine c plus d by 2. What? This theta I bring here, this theta I bring here. This 2 into 2, 4, I balance there. There is an x square into x, that was x cubed. What is the problem? What is the problem, please? Oh, this, sorry. By e to the power 2x, this one, you're saying. A squared minus B squared. Yeah, where is there any other extra 2 sitting?
Two.
No? Okay. So then, this would be sine theta by theta tends to 0, 1. Sine theta by theta tends to 0 equal to 1. This would be half. And this limit is half of limit e power minus 2x minus e power 2x by x as x tends to 0. Can I write this as half of limit e power minus 2x minus 1 by x minus e power x minus 1 by x as x tends to 0? Yes or no? I can multiply this with a minus 2 here, and a minus 2 here comes here. Comes there. So e power something minus 1 by something tends to 0 would be 1. So minus 2 minus 1. That makes it minus 3 by 2. There is a 2 outside there. Please ask. Bolo, kya confusion? This step. After this. I wrote as this minus 1, this minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 will get cancelled. Divide by x. Sorry? Oh, e power, oh, I'm sorry. E power 2x by 2x into 2. Sorry. So, minus 2, minus 2, minus 4. So, minus 2. Thank you. As h tends to 0, numerator is not tending to 0. It cannot be minus, this should be plus then. Because otherwise the limit will not exist, see. If it was minus, numerator not tending to 0, denominator tending to 0. But if it is plus, as h tends to 0, 2a power x minus 2a power x, numerator and denominator both tend to 0 now. Right, this will make sense. So then, to take the next step into this, this is like limit a power h plus a power minus h minus 2 by h squared as h tends to 0, right? A power x multiplying by a power h, both numerator denominator, a power 2h minus 2a power h plus 1 by h squared a power h as h tends to 0. Right? A power h minus 1 by h whole squared as h tends to 0. Yes or no? Right? This would be log a. This would be 1 into a power x. A power x into log a whole squared, log a whole squared. Anyone? 30? You want? Take it. 30 is very simple actually. 30 limit x tends to 0. Ln 1 plus x. Prince Kumar. PKC. Right? This would be 1. This would be log 3. One to power infinity form. You want me to solve this? Okay. Yeah, limit x tends to 0. 1 plus 2x to power 5 by x. 1 to power infinity form. So this is going to be limit x tends to 0. E to power 5 by x into this minus 1. This minus 1 is 2x. So that makes it e to power 10. Whole to power 1 by 2x. Absolutely, no problem. Perfect. Next one must be wrong. It must be x tends to infinity. So that it can become 1 to power infinity. There is a typo here in 32, x tends to infinity. Then it will be 1 to power infinity form. Do I need to solve this? 33? Your attention please. Hello? Now this can be written as limit. 1 can be written as log e. Log x by e. I take e common from this. X by e minus 1. And this x by e I can write as x by e minus 1 plus 1. Yes or no? As x tends to e. Yes or no? As x tends to e, x by e minus 1 tends to 0. Log 1 plus something by something as something tends to 0 is going to be 1 by e. So that makes it 1 by e. Yes or no? It should not be ln log 2 to the base x. Right? ln 2 by ln x, x tends to 1. Minus x minus 1. Log 2 log x minus 1 plus 1 as x tends to 1. Yes or no? As x tends to 1, x minus 1 tends to 0. So log 1 plus something divided by something as something tends to 0 is going to be 1. It leaves you with log 2. I know you are tired. Just two more problems. Then we can get started with another sheet. Next class. Right. See, x to power x can be written as e power x ln x. A to power a can be written as e power a ln a. Right? I take e power a ln a common from this. Why? So that you'll realize x ln x minus a minus 1. See, as x tends to a, this will tend to 0. As x tends to a, this will tend to 0. So e power something minus 1. So I should bring in a something here. That something tends to 0. So this is that something. X ln x minus a ln a is that something. Right? Into x ln x minus a ln a by x minus a. As x tends to a, yes or no? E power something minus 1 by something. This I brought from outside. As x tends to a, this tends to 0. E power something minus 1 by something, something. This is going to be 1. That means we are just left with this to deal with. X ln x minus a ln a by x minus a. That's the only thing to be dealt with. Right? So as x tends to a, x ln x minus a ln a by x minus a as x tends to a. Clear? Oh, e power a ln a was there, which I missed out throughout. Thanks for pointing that out. X tends to a, I took e power a ln a common. But e power a ln a is actually a power a. Is a power a, so there'll be a power a coming out, right? E power a ln a I took common. Right? So that's a power a. Haan, bolo. So this one, this is like a power a limit x minus a ln x, so that when I divide by x minus a and then plus a ln a. So, x, sorry. So, ln x minus ln a divided by x minus a. See what I've done here as x tends to a. See, this x I wrote as x minus a. This x I wrote as x minus a. That means this minus a ln x was an alien that I brought. So, I balanced it with a ln x, and the a ln a was already sitting there. Do you realize what I did here? And now on dividing, this will simply be ln x. We are just left with this limit to deal with, right? This is a power a limit ln x plus a ln x by a. Right? This would be a x by a divided by x minus a as x tends to a. Right? See, now I take a common from this, or rather I use this a to divide x by a minus 1. I write this x by a as x by a minus 1 plus 1. As x tends to a, x by a minus 1 tends to 0. Ln 1 plus something by something as something tends to 0 is 1. So this will become 1 and this will become ln a. This will become 1 and this will become ln a. So this is like a power a into ln a plus 1. That's the answer. Ln x as x tends to a will be ln a, na? Right?